The following is an article published in the journal A Tarde on January 29, 2015 by Divaldo Pereira Franco, entitled Love for Life. Human existence is the most precious gift. Even with the gravity of the hour, with its terrible violent meshes, aggressiveness and torments of various kinds, it is worth living, having plenitude as the goal. Many people think exclusively about themselves, dominated by an asphyxiating egotism and the misleading psychological construction that they will be happy like this, because they have lost the way to equilibrium, wisdom, and reason. However, when they believe themselves triumphant, they find themselves submerged in an existential void, and soon after they tumble in grave psychological disorders. The meaning of life is resumed in the self-edification through love, through the effort to live under the support of the right thoughts, the correct words, and a healthy conduct. Only in this way will your struggles be those that provide you with a sense on how to behave and a stimulus for legitimate advances in the conquest of the self. The material objectives, even with their edifying purpose, are easy to obtain, which is what provides the need for continuous programming. Furthermore, they present turbulent confrontations, which may be the competitiveness that is not always done in a dignified manner, the submission to the context in which one lives, now characterized by bribery, injury, distrust, the fear of the loss of values acquired or of positions obtained, the inevitable intimate dissatisfaction that flows from the anxiety of always wanting to possess more and to shine even more. The human creature is the measure of its moral or spiritual aspirations that project it towards illumination. It seems like naivety to aspire for inner illumination, peace in the heart, when the swords of Damocles hang over every head ready to cut them off. They are, therefore, the naive proposals of love, as preconized by Jesus Christ, that provide well-being, the joy of living, work in the good, fraternity in its broadest sense. This is how the unforgettable Galilean poet lived, loving in a hostile epoch such as ours. Could we try the same?